Hey guys, happy Thanksgiving. I hope you're enjoying your time with your family. If you're in New York, I don't know what's going on if you have a big family, because New York Governor Cuomo released some some orders. He had a mandate that stated that you can't have more than 10 people gather for religious services or something like that. If they're in a red zone, if they're in an orange zone, it can be as many as 25 one place. And a lot of states, they have a lot of restrictions on, oh, you shouldn't have more than this amount of people in one place at one time and all this. Well, anyway, the United States Supreme Court ruled against Governor Cuomo, saying that it's clearly the wrong. I don't see how you can issue something like that. For one thing, we have a First Amendment right to peacefully assemble. I know you have to have permits for certain types of assemblies or protests or whatever, but to assemble in your own home, to bring people into your own house, I know there's certain guidelines, but it seems like that would be a violation of the First Amendment. And then, you know, there's a whole issue of, you know, religious rights as far as religious assembly. The way that governor's handled the whole situation, I don't see why he really believes he's the authority. I guess he's using the opinions of certain officials, but when it comes to authority figures, they've been wrong about a lot of stuff. They've been wrong about a lot in this whole pandemic. And just because you have a pandemic, that doesn't mean that, okay, you can throw away certain constitutional rights. Well, anyway, it was a 5-4 decision. Not a surprise, Roberts joined the liberals, as they say. Why do they keep saying John Roberts joins the liberals? If he's always joining the liberals, isn't he just one of the liberals? This so-called 6-3 conservative majority. Like, dude, that makes no sense. When it comes to the really meaningful cases, look at where this guy really falls. Look at where he really rules votes. Speaking of voting, the saga continues. 2020 saga continues. No, it's not officially over, although President Trump has initiated the process of transition so that Biden will be better prepared when he takes over in next year, early next year. So that's a little good news for him. And we don't want chaos. We don't want another election night, of course, but stop the voting. We're going to do something in the back room. We wake up tomorrow, it'll be something different. Anyway, speaking of which, Sidney Powell, she's a well-known attorney who represented General Flynn, who was recently pardoned by Donald Trump, President Trump, after 4 years of dealing with a legal situation where he lied to the FBI. And anyway, this is a whole drama around there. But she helped him in that case. He was his attorney. Now she's going after Dominion voting systems. What's interesting about Dominion, the software, the whole voting machine situation, is that company, they just started shutting down offices after she started making these accusations. I mean, if they were innocent of all the stuff of rigging this election, like, wouldn't they come out and try to defend themselves? Why wouldn't they file a countersuit for, anyway? But I don't think that's really happened. She filed two big lawsuits in two states, one in Georgia, one in Michigan. In Georgia, the situation looks really sketchy. She's claiming that 69,000 votes just disappeared. They were absentee votes that didn't really fully get counted, which is kind of interesting. You got to remember the margin in Georgia is around just 12,000 or so. It really wasn't a lot. They did a recount, but they didn't really change the way they did it. They actually counted it. They didn't verify the signatures. But even then, Trump picked up a couple thousand or so votes because they simply found votes. She's claiming that at one point in Fulton County, Atlanta, the Atlanta area, Fulton County, they said there was some type of water damage situation or flooding or whatever. They cleared out the area where they're counting votes, and they had certain individuals there unmonitored until 1 o'clock with the votes, with the ballots. She's claiming that. She's claiming a number of things that are pretty sketchy. We'll see. I mean, we'll definitely see if she can actually prove it. And that's a big deal. That's a big thing for me. I'm hearing a lot of talk, and obviously not a lot's going to happen during Thanksgiving. But next week, I think it's a do or die type of situation for this. So for the Trump legal team. Yeah, Sidney Powell, who the Trump team separated themselves, where they're saying that she's not an official attorney for Donald Trump. She's doing her own thing with the whole, she's basically saying that there was systematic fraud in the system in multiple states. And what they're saying is they did things incorrectly or errors. For example, they were counting votes in Pennsylvania beyond 8 o'clock, beyond the period where they were legally allowed to count votes. That's what they're trying to claim. There's two different type of things going on right here. You got the Giuliani Trump team saying that, hey, there were some people were acting outside the law. There were some errors. Certain votes, certain legal votes weren't counted that should have. Certain illegal votes were counted that shouldn't have been counted. Then you have Sidney Powell, who's saying that this is a outright fraudulent system and I'm going to prove it. And she seems to be really, really confident in her ability to prove it. We'll see if it really happens. I'm glad the Supreme Court put the brakes on some of this lockdown, COVID-19 nonsense that you're seeing from a lot of these governors. What's interesting is that they make big mistakes. Like, for example, New York Governor Cuomo put those COVID-19 patients in those nursing homes, which had disastrous consequences. But then, you know, they're back telling you how to live your life. And you know, it's like, if I screwed up that badly, I don't know if I would be that confident in saying, well, now this is what you're going to do next. These are, Jerry Salente's right. These are some power hungry individuals. The way I see it, we still have to take some responsibility for it, because somebody voted these people in. Somebody said, yeah, this is the guy I want to lead me. And a lot of people said that. And when it comes to Biden, if he is president next year, and you know, hey, a lot of people supported it. I think in Pennsylvania, after he made his position clear on energy, should have been a blowout victory for Donald Trump. Should have been a lot like Ohio. You know, it's amazing that a candidate could do so well in Ohio and Florida, but then do so poorly in Georgia and Pennsylvania. Right next to one another. I know they're different states, but it's really interesting. You know, you're doing really well with Latinos in South Texas and Florida, but all of a sudden in Arizona, you're not doing well enough. I think Arizona, a lot of that had to do with a lot of Californians moving there. But there's also some questionable activities going on in Arizona as well. So these are the things that are pretty much on my mind. Ammunition, guns, ammo. Hey, look, if you're looking for a deal on anything like that, you're pretty much out of luck right now. It's going to be a long time before we get decent ammo prices, decent ammo, just availability. It's just, I go to these stores and I'm just, wow. The shelves are empty. There's nothing there. Like 12 gauge bird shot and, I don't know, 6.5 Creedmoor and some obscure caliber. Just what is this? No 45, no, it's just rough. I think it's going to be maybe even, I wouldn't be surprised if it takes another year for it to get anywhere near normal. But these are the times we're living in. Again, just be prepared. I hope you did prepare, because the thing about prepping is you do have time until you don't. And when you don't, your options become much more limited. That's why I'm always talking about it. So you can still get emergency food, freeze-dried food. You can still get water. You can still go to the grocery store, get some water. You can still get a first aid kit, medical stuff. This is stuff you can still do. You can still order holsters. You can still do stuff like that. Good luck finding armor, but you know, emergency food, you can still get stuff like that. So I hope you take advantage of the opportunities you may have. Hey, water filter, water filtration tablets, water filter. You can't get ammo or whatever, but you can still get this stuff. It's not all about guns and ammo. There's other things you can do as well. So just because you can't find one thing doesn't mean that you should just, oh well, I give up on everything. There's still some areas where you can help yourself. So keep that in mind. Thank you for watching. Oh, look for flashlights too. Another thing you do, if you can't find magazines or ammo you're looking for, you can't find ammo, look for the magazines. Can't find the magazines, get some good flashlights. That's some good prepping items. But anyway, thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.